In a previous lesson, you learned how to compare fractions with a few different types of methods. And in this lesson, we are adding two more ways to compare fractions. The first way is by renaming as a decimal, and the second way is by cross multiplying. So let's begin with the first method. So to begin with, we are going to compare by renaming the fractions as a decimal. So we've learned in a previous lesson as well that we can convert a fraction into a decimal. So for example, if we had the numbers 4/5 and 3/4, we could convert each of these into a decimal and then compare the decimal equivalents. So this one, 4/5, is one we should have memorized, and that is 0.8, and 3/4 can be memorized as 0.75. So assuming that we have those memorized, we can now use the decimal equivalents and compare. We know that 0.8 or 0.80, same thing, is greater than 0.75. So because 0.8 is greater than 0.75, we know that 4/5 is greater than 3/4. In example two, we have two more fractions, but here, these are not commonly memorized fractions. We don't know the decimal equivalents typically off the top of our head. So what we must do is we need to convert by dividing. So for example, 6/7, we can convert into a decimal by dividing. So we could do this by hand, or you could use a calculator. But if we do it by hand, what you do is you take the 6 and divide by 7. And then from here, we need to add a decimal and a zero. And 7 does not go into 6, but 7 does go into 60. And 7 goes into 60 8 times. So let's put 8 up here. Decimal goes right there. 8 times 7 is 56. And then we subtract, and then we get 4. And then we can put a 0 here, bring it down, repeat. 7 goes into 40 5 times, so 5 goes here. Then we multiply 5 times 7 to get 35. Subtract, we get 5, and we could keep going if we need to. Now 13/15, we can do the same exact thing. So we take 13 divided by 15, we add a decimal and a zero, and 15 does not go into 13, but it goes into 130, and that would go into 130 8 times. Decimal point goes here, 8 times 15, we'd get 40, carry the 4, 120. Then we subtract, we get 10. Add a zero, bring it down, and repeat the process. So then 15 goes into 100 6 times. 6 times 15 is 90, subtract, and we get 10. And we could repeat the process if we need to. But notice what we have. We have 0.86 and 0.85. So 0.86 is clearly bigger, and 0.86 corresponded with the 13/15. So 13/15 is bigger, or in other words, 6/7 is smaller. So 6/7 is less than 13/15. So this is how we can compare fractions by renaming as a decimal. Now the second approach that we could use is by using a process called cross multiplying. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the same exact fractions we used in the previous slide, and we're going to show this other method. So we had 4/5 and 3/4 as our first set of fractions. And it's color coordinated to help you visualize what we're doing. Now the process is really in the name itself. So it says cross multiplying. What we are doing is we're multiplying across. What we mean is if you look at the yellow numbers right here, the 4 and the 4, we would multiply across, meaning we'd multiply these two together. So multiply the 4 times the 4, and then we multiply the other numbers, the 3 and the 5. So we multiply across the 3 and the 5. So what we have is 4 times 4, and we have 3 times 5. So the 4 times 4 would go on the left side, and the 3 times 5 goes on the right side. And what we do is we compare these numbers. So 4 times 4 is 16, 3 times 5 is 15. 16 is greater than 15. So that means because 16 is greater than 15, 4/5 is greater than 3/4. And by the way, this is right here, those three dots, that means therefore. So therefore, 4/5 is greater than 3/4. Okay, let's try another one. Here we had 6 over 7 and 13 over 15. So again, what we do is we multiply across. So multiply across 6 times 15, and then we multiply across where we have 13 times 7. So 6 times 15 and 13 times 7 are the numbers we're comparing. 6 times 15 goes on the left side, and 13 times 7 goes on the right side. 6 times 15 is 90, 13 times 7 is 91. So we compare those two numbers, and 90 is less than 91. So therefore, 6 over 7 is less than 13 over 15. All right, so this way is quicker many times, and we don't need to convert into a decimal or our other methods as well. So at this point, we've learned many different approaches to determine which fraction is bigger. And after this lesson, you can use whatever method is easiest for you. So that concludes our lesson for today. We will see you next time.